It is with a heavy heart that we all have assembled here. Our brothers and sisters belonging to West Bengal and Gujarat are increasingly being subjected to murder, mayhem, and oppression. When such news ceaselessly pour in, we cannot remain with peace of mind. It is this unrest that prompted us to come to Delhi in protest. An open day like murder of democracy is taking place in the states of West Bengal and Tripura. Human rights and political freedom have come under severe strain. This is increasingly being seen all across the country. As for example, in the brutal suppression of people's products, as well as use of draconian laws against human rights activities. However, this has come into sharp focus in West Bengal and Tripura, strongholds of the left movement in the country. Politics of violence and terror continues to be unleashed by the ruling BJP IPFT government in Tripura and the Trinamool Congress government in West Bengal. In Tripura, during the Left Front's tenures, we had ensured that the state made quantum leaps in all sectors. The state made enviable advances in the defense of tribal rights and cultures. It achieved one of the highest rates of poverty reduction, a record increase in agricultural yields, and a record growth in electricity production. Education was made available to all, and the state achieved total literacy. Now, healthcare facilities and industrial units were set up. It also achieved one of the highest road densities in the country under the Left Front government. Tripura had even become a role model for the entire country in curbing insurgency through confidence building measures and in achieving lasting peace. It was the first insurgency affected state which was able to repeal the imposition of the draconian ASPA. Only the BJP RSS coming can convert it into a land of massacre, lynching, ethnic feud, and intolerance in just a matter of days. The BJP IPFT campaign have been resorting to violence even before and during the elections, and even a journalist, Shantanu Bhoumik, had lost his life then. Create ethnic discord and destroy the unity of the people. That was the real face of the democracy espoused by the BJP RSS in Tripura even prior to the elections. Their commitment to democracy was evident when they grabbed the statues of the main opposition party. Their commitment to democracy was evident when they grabbed the status of the main opposition party without winning even a single seat in the previous elections by getting Congress MLAs who had defeated to the TMC to further defected to the BJP. One can only imagine if those legislatures had in fact defected or if they had been bored. Ever since the BJP IPFT government assumed office in Tripura, the CPIM, the Democratic Mass Organizations, and the Left Front as a whole have been the targets of the violence perpetrated by the BJP and RSS. It started right after the election results were announced, with even constitutional offices occupied by BJP RSS sympathizers, justifying violence and vandalism in which Lenin's statue was raised down. Four CPIM comrades have been muscle sends to the assembly area. 1,000 death captives, including 100 women, have suffered injuries. Apart from physically targeting death cadres, even programs and events conducted by the CPIM and other left parties have come under attack. Even May Day celebrations were thought to be disrupted in various parts of the state. Programs commemorating Karma's bicentenary are being attacked. The progressive Navy, Desharkara, has become a target with transporters carrying the bus paper as well as subscribers being threatened. Pradhans, chairmen, and elected members of various local bodies, including the Tribura Tribal Areas Autonomous District Council, are being coerced either to resign or join the BJP. The complicity of the state administration in this random incidence of violence is revealed by the fact that our leaders are being attacked even inside the police station where they go to lodge complaints. The fact that such wild incidents are happening under an elected government is appalling, to say the least. The elected government of Tribura should adhere to its constitutional duty of providing safety to the lives and livelihoods of the people it governs, irrespective of the politics they have. It is for the government to repose their faith in the process of democracy and democratic institutions. If the state government is unable to be faithful to the constitution, people will take them to task. The CPIM-led left-wing governments have ensured peace in Tribura in the past, and we are capable of restoring peace once again. The state of affairs is even more. The state of affairs in West Bengal is even more worrying. In West Bengal, the TMC regime has been maintaining its reign of terror and semi-fascistic attacks directed against the death penalty. Back in 2011, when they had won elections, they had resorted to mindless violence against our cadres and officers on a large scale. This time around, they are unleashing violence with even higher levels of inhumanness and cruelty. After the 2016 assembly elections, the TMC launched widespread attacks against the left parties, particularly in areas where the CPIM and the other left parties continue to retain their mass base. More than 11 activists of the left parties have lost their lives in the course of the Panchayat elections related violence alone. We all know of Debudas and Ushadas, the couple who were burned alive inside their home. The only reason for their gruesome murder was that they were CPIM workers. Abduction and arson are banned in West Bengal even today. The police administration is in complete cahoots with the TMC groups. This is the present situation of a state which can be really be proud of glorious history. Bengal's contribution to the whole of India is unparalleled. It is noted for its revolutionary history right from the reformation movement to the development of the leftist movement right through the independence struggle. Bengal is the home of some of the greatest visionaries of the world, a unique blend of social reformers, religious leaders, scholars, literary giants, scientists, artists, etc. has made Bengal stand apart. Bengali Renaissance, which witnessed an intellectual awakening, stands as a beacon light for Indian society as a whole till this day. This movement questioned existing orthodoxies, particularly with respect to women, marriage, the dowry system, the caste system, and religion. One of the earlier social movements that emerged during this time espoused rationalism as the common denominators of civil conduct. The ways that Raja Ram Mohan Roy
Swami Vivekananda, etc., procured out from Bengal, swept through much of India, and kindled the light of social information in our society. The initiative taken by Rajaram Mohan Roy to eradicate the inhuman system of Sadi influenced the conscious of Indian society and instilled a new sense of human tenderness in it. We have witnessed the magnificence of Bengali literature. The current TMC government in West Bengal remains the present Rabindranath Tagore's Nastanidra. The while promising democracy and freedom at the national level, the TMC is behaving like a bunch of ghouls who are courting democracy and freedom at every possible instant in the very own backyard. It is indeed a matter of great pain and concern for India as a whole that a region which has made such vibrant contributions to the formation of our country and our republic is now in an abysmal state of efforts. During the left front governments, West Bengal was known for its progressive and secular outlook. But it pains me to ask, where does it stand today? Tagore dreamt that this country would awaken into a heaven of freedom, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Sadly, his homeland is now broken up into more fragments than it was ever before, owing to the TMC government's misrule in the state. Freedom is but a dream in today's Bengal. To regain it is the best way to pay homage to the memories of Rabindranath Tagore, who sang, "Where the mind is without fear, where the head is held high." The Supreme Court, in a case the hearing of which continues, has recently observed that grassroots level democracy, as enshrined in the Constitution, is not working in West Bengal. It is the duty of all of us who work to strengthen democracy to ensure that the state government of West Bengal is taken to task on their continuous efforts to undermine our constitutional provisions. Their delusion of duty should be thoroughly exposed before the people of our country. The dangerous developments in these two states are part of the larger attacks on the livelihoods and the hard-earned rights of the people. It is a weapon which is sought to weaken democracy. The Trinamool Congress and the BJP RSS campaign are both working towards this end. People are being denied safety and security, which are the constitutional obligations of elected governments. I strongly condemn this daylight murder of democracy in West Bengal and Tripura. I sincerely urge all those across the country who believe in democracy and our constitution to protest this butchery and strongly condemn this barbarity. I take this opportunity to express the solidarity of the people of Kerala as a whole to those who bravely confront the onslaughts of the anti-democratic hoodlums. The Indian people as a whole should come forward to defeat such fascistic attacks being mounted on our constitution, people's democratic rights and civil liberty. I hope all democratic forces will join together in the defense of democracy, human rights and civil liberty, upholding the cherished values of the Indian Republic. Thank you.